I'm loving your light, vulnerable. Letting your guard down, it's honorable. Especially when the past ain't been that friendly to you, but there's magic in that.
You know you're blessed when your friends come over and do stuff like this. Hey y'all, I'm on my way to my 6 week follow-up appointment. It's been well over 6 weeks, even though y'all are still saying it's late. It's been well over 6 weeks. Because I wanted to see my specific doctor and not one of her midwives, so I had to wait a little while longer. But yeah, I'll let y'all know. I mean, as far as my postpartum, I feel great and I feel back to normal, which is really, really cool. The only thing that feels different is the fact that I have somebody with me now at all times. So I'll keep y'all updated, let you know how it goes. Baby is 7 weeks as of today and he's doing well as well. I know y'all be seeing my chin hairs in these videos. Please let me know, besides laser, what do y'all do? Because I know I ain't the only person with this problem. And it's definitely not a postpartum thing. I'm sure postpartum has brought more of them down. Like my hormones and stuff have brought more. But I have had these for a couple years now. It's like hereditary. My mom and grandma experienced them. So I will too. Or I am. But anyway, we got to pull off so I can make it on to my appointment on time. I'm also going to go pick up a bassinet. Just want to have a place for him to sleep when he's at their house and they're watching him and things. As y'all saw, my friend came over to cut my grass. Since I've been in my home, my next door neighbor, her son has cut my grass. Who else? Somebody cut my grass. I just don't remember who the hell it was. But people have been blessing me cutting my grass, which is amazing. But that ain't gonna be forever. As a homeowner, expenses are real, and I really am starting to see the benefits of staying in an apartment. However, for me and mine personally, I thought the benefit was much larger and more impactful to have my own, in terms of just legacy and investment, having things to pass down, heirlooms, creating generational wealth, or starting that and filling that gap with my family. All of that stuff outweighed having a maintenance man. So, because it's really cool when you have people that you know and that you trust and that really love you and want to see you not in need. You know, like I said, people are cutting my grass. It's just amazing how nice people have been. But it's also great knowing people who have their own businesses that can provide services for you at an affordable rate as well. So, just blessed. I'm just blessed. All in all, I will say that being a homeowner is a really cool thing. I mean, it's so much comfort coming home and putting your key in your door, laying your head on that bed in a home that belongs to you, as long as you're making those mortgage payments. But when it's paid off and it's all said and done, it's just a really good feeling to know that this is yours and nobody can take it away from you after you've paid it off. You know what I'm saying? So there is security in that fact. Oh, I realized I never gave this update on my channel about my baby. I just mentioned that, you know, we were not seeing him gain the way that we wanted to in terms of weight. So y'all saw that I went to the lactation class, which was really nice. And I kept talking about it in that vlog. I didn't realize how many times I talked about my experience there. But that's really good. So y'all know I actually got something from it. Let me get this point across and then I'm going to go. But what was I about to say? Oh, he's doing well. Although he may have started off slower than other babies, some babies just do things at their own rates, and all babies do things at their own rates, matter of fact. But yeah, he's definitely a chunkier baby now. Feeding is going really well for him. I'm producing. Supply and demand is in effect. The more he's suckling, the more the milk is coming. So I have no complaints. Baby's still sleeping throughout the night, y'all. I have an angel. Like, we are so much in sync, and he has the same schedule pretty much that he had when he was in my stomach. Like I said, I'll update y'all on the appointment and how everything's going. And I do my last yoni steam tomorrow. The last time I did one was 1 week ago, and this collection of herbs is supposed to keep my period from coming back. And I told y'all I may have already come back on, but I'm just not sure yet. So next month will actually be a telltale sign if the herbs definitely have slowed down or stopped my cycle. She said, I think she said between 9 and 12 months. All right, so I just got on the main road off out of the community. So now I am going to
it's
go.
It's kind
of
my love. Forevermore.
Does anybody switch in between singing voices or is that just me? Anyways, so we just left the 6-week follow-up. Went well, pretty fast. Like, I don't know why I was expecting it to be elaborate, but she just asked me how I was doing. I got to get the car moving soon because he likes to move. But yeah, I'm about to go drive and pick up the first bassinet. My sister picked up the other one yesterday, so I think that's at her house. So I'm gonna pick it up from Kamala's house, who y'all met on my vlog. I think that was like my 7-day postpartum vlog that I posted with her in it. But anyways, yeah, I'll talk to y'all in a little bit. Peace.
And then
you on a vlog.
Hey.
You was about to start going in.
Girl. Hey, y'all. How are y'all doing?
Y'all, this is Frances. She just chilling. We're not doing hair today. She moving. You want to tell them what you want to tell them? It's up to you how much you want to share.
I mean, your girl is moving.
First of all, tell them who you are in case this is their first time looking at my vlog.
I'm Frances. I am the woman who is responsible for the locks on Miss Soleil's head.
Yes.
That's my girl, knows my babies.
Yes.
And my baby. but yes. And I am here in the city because I am moving and I was coming to collect some things for my new apartment.
Mm-hmm.
So
And tell people that when they ask me who started my locks, that I'm not lying when I say that she don't live here no more. She's a flight attendant.
So once again, at this current moment, no, I am not taking any more clients at this moment because I'm not here in the Richmond area. And the only time that I am here, that's when I'm getting my hair done, and me and Soleil have a thing where we work out. When I'm getting mine done, you know, I can get her in as well too. So, because Anna likes to go to other people, and I understand where she's coming from too.
Okay.
She's in the man. Hey, Kim. but yeah, so at this current moment, no. Once I get situated where I am, then I may be available, you know, for at least just doing reties, but installs, the way that my my schedule is right now, it's really kind of hard for me to do installs and have multiple clients. But just be available or not be available, but
on standby.
Be on standby. Thank you.
For the next update. She'll update y'all when she does my hair again. Not the next time, but at some point.
At some point.
Come show them your locks real quick. So these are her locks. She got some color in them. They are gorgeous.
I've had them for...
Come back one more time. Because my camera keeps going out of focus. There it is. They are gorgeous. And she got lock sprinkles. Oh, baby crying. Where is it? Turn to the... Yeah, so they can see it. That's pretty.
Can you see?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, they're here, girls. They're here, ladies and fellas, if you can see. But,
gorgeous.
2012 is when I got them. We're in 2019, so that's what?
Seven years? Yeah.
So I've had them for 7 years. I did cut them. You know, us ladies, when we go through things, we gotta take control over life. So I said, you know what? Let me cut my hair. But yeah, best decision ever. So for any of y'all who are out there who are interested in locks, sister locks, you know, preferably, I would say go for it. Go for it. You're going to get them and you'll be like, why didn't I get it a long time ago?
Exactly.
Or why did I wait this long?
And go to the Sisterlocks website for a detailed list of who's, you know, currently certified at least.
Absolutely.
Because there's a lot of people that might say they know how to do them, but you know.
Especially now, definitely go on the site and just make sure that you do see somebody's name. I will say that, you know, there are people who are certified, but you got to go and get, you know, retested, but
it's things you got to do to keep your name on the website.
To keep your name on the list. I mean, by all means, you may not see my name because I ain't did it, but yeah. I know what I'm doing.
Her name was on there when I got mine.
Right. And so. I could have tried. Anyway.
It might still be on there because they don't update these.
They don't.
Girl, the website is it needs an update.
If you want somebody that you know for sure knows what they're doing, definitely check out the website.
I'm sorry, y'all. Oh, yes, honey. Yes, okay. But like I was saying, when you do your consultations, make sure that you know, like when you're doing a job, they're interviewing you just as much as you're interviewing them. So you want to make sure that you vibe well with the person that you have planned to do your locks. Because I did go through, you know, a few consultations because I just didn't vibe well. And I'm like, if I'm going to have your hands in my hair and spend this pretty penny, you know, I want to make sure that, you know, I don't have any issues with that person. So definitely that was one of the big things for me that I would like for people to know. Make sure that, you know, not that they're just a nice person and things of that nature. Yeah, you still want to see their work. But,
true.
Yeah. Yeah. Soleil's cool. She's all right.
Aw. They'd be like, we know, sis.
Right. Just saying, you know. But no, so yeah. But if you
definitely, I've made a new friend getting my hair done. So it's pretty good.
Likewise. That's my girl. Like, I can't even say that's my client anymore. Like, yeah. That's my friend. Yeah. Okay? Mm-hmm. And it's really good when you can say that.
Facts.
But by all means, like I said, stay, be on standby because, you know, there may be some things in the future in the works. But as of right now, no. To answer the big question, I am not taking any more clients. Mm-hmm. Sorry, y'all. Sorry.
Okay, Francis is gone. I wanted to show y'all something. This is my office. I painted that wall yellow. But I am going to, debating if I want to do the entire room yellow, but I know I'm going to do that one yellow. And possibly this one back here. I'm going to put a futon back there. I just got that desk from somebody on the Facebook Marketplace. It's an IKEA desk. I know it looks a hot mess right now, but baby was sitting in here this morning. I know that's a mess. I checked my mail and threw the mail right in here. But yeah, he was sitting here because I started school today. So I was on my laptop taking an online class. Got my notes over there. And he was knocked out. So I'm going to do about 2 more hours of my class. I did 2 this morning. And I'm going to put him here, swaddle him up because that's the trick to keeping him asleep while I get this done. And go back to school. Then we'll take a nap. It has been a really cool day. It's raining now. But at least I'm getting things done around the house. My trip to Hobby Lobby yesterday got me that cute little, I don't even know what to call that, ottoman-ish thing. Got some pictures down here on the floor. Got some other pictures that I'm going to sell. I got a rug. I got all kind of stuff. So I'm getting this room together slowly but surely. And it's going to be great for my new business. Because I have an actual space to get things done in. So anyways, y'all, I'll catch up with you in a little bit. I'm so glad I got rid of those bar stools. I am gonna miss them because they were super cute. They were in my apartment, but I don't need them anymore. So anyways, back to being a studious student.